unit of tan. Now, you all are knowing what is cloth. By this we can consider that clock is showing the pair hours. One day is having 24 hours. There are certain parameters of the units. One day is equal to 24 hours. 1 hour is equal to 60 minute. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. See, this you all are knowing, right? Now, month. In this, while calculating, we have to consider 1 month. As 30 days. How we have to consider this as a 30 days. 1 week is equal to 7 days. See, you all are knowing all these things. You might be thinking, why teacher is explaining all this? But here you have to learn how to convert this. Means these are the bigger unit and these are the smaller unit. So when you convert bigger unit to the smaller unit, you have to always multiply. What you have to do? When we convert big unit to small unit, we have to multiply. When we convert small unit to big unit, we have to divide. Whatever you are converting, your answer will be right. Suppose here 1 week is the big unit and 7 days are the smaller unit. So if I want to convert 2 weeks into the days or 4 weeks into the days, what I have to do? Look here. 4 weeks. Here suppose, example, convert into 4 weeks multiplied by how many days a 1 week has? 1 week is equal to 7 days, that we all know, right? So 4 multiplied by 7, 4 7 is 28. how to convert the narration of the time, subtraction of the time. But before we go into the details, I have observed many times that children are often confused with when to use AM and when to use PM. So first we will, I will explain you that. Okay. Just now I told you that our clock is showing 12 hours time, right? So 12:00 midnight.
Addition and subtraction.
Okay, so now I will explain you how we can add up and subtract the time. See, this is somewhat different than the regular addition and subtraction. For example, if I take your hour and minute, right? So 6 hours and 85 minutes, and I have to add up with that 1 hour and 12 minutes. So first I have to add this 5 plus 2, 7, 8 plus 1, 9. Now 97 minutes. I cannot carry this 9 over here. Why? Because this is showing the minutes. Now I have to subtract 60 minutes from 8. That is 1 hour. So what I have to write here? 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Right? So I have to subtract it from here and then I can carry that 60 minutes up 1 hour.
So I have to subtract here 12. Understand?
3 and 0. And this 1 year I am getting here. 5 plus 1 is 6 plus 2 is 7. So 7 years and 3 months. Understand? So what you have to learn here, children? Addition of odds and ends, then addition of limits. Addition of limits and seconds. Addition of minutes and seconds, addition of years and months. Same you have to apply for the weeks also and then another parameter also. Now I will explain you subtraction. Okay? So we will use the next page.
Thank you.
and your one total, many are carried, so 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Right? So, this 5 seconds plus 60 seconds is equal to 65 seconds. Right? This, whatever we are borrowing from your bed, that we have to convert into the second, and then we have to add up it in the seconds or in the minute. So, here I have to write 65, 5 minus 0, 5, 6 minus 1, 5. Now, 9 minus, here 49, so 9 minus 5, 4, and 4 minus 2, 2. So, what is the answer? 24 minutes and 55 seconds. Understand? So, this we have subtract. Seconds and minutes, minutes and seconds, here we have subtracted hours and minutes. Now we will go through one sum of the years and the month. Okay. So suppose years and month. 15 years and 8 months. And 5 years and 10 months. Now can I subtract these 10 months from the 8 months? No. So from here I have to borrow one full year. So 15 will become 40. And 1 year is equal to 12 months. Right? 1 year is equal to 12 months. So 12 I have borrowed, 8 I was having. So, it has become now 20 months. So, what I have to write here? 20 months. Now, 0 minus 0, 2 minus 1, 1. I cannot subtract 4 from the 5. So, I will borrow from here. 20 minus 5, 9. So, what is the answer? 9 years and 10 months. If I subtract 5 years and 10 months from the 15 years and 8 months, I will know this answer, 9 years and 10 months. Understand, children? So, this was all about the addition and subtraction of time. Now, I will explain you how to convert the time. How to convert the time. Completion of the chapter, you will learn the converting of time by addition and subtraction and what is AM and PM, where you have to use AM and PM. So now I am explaining you convert the time. Just now I told you that when you convert the time, you have to always first think whether you have to convert from the bigger unit to smaller unit or from the smaller unit to the bigger unit, right? So suppose convert into, here it is written into days, right? Now, what is given to you? 2 years. Now, which one is the bigger unit? Days or year? So, you are doing that year are the bigger unit. So, what you have to do here? 1 year is equal to 365 days, right? So, what I have to do here? 2 multiplied by 365. Right? So, 2 5 are 10, 1 carry, 2 6 are 12 plus 1, 3, 13, 1 carry, 2 3 are 6 plus 1, 7. So, what is the answer? 730 days. Understand, children? So, when you convert the big unit to the small unit, we have to always multiply, right? Now, convert the weeks into days. Weeks into days. Suppose 49 converts, no, sorry, convert into Bs and As. 49 days. This you have to convert into weeks and days both. So days are the smaller unit and weeks are the bigger unit, right? So what you have to do? You have to divide. So I know that 1 day is equal to 7 days, right? So what I have to do here? 49 divided by 7. Okay. Or else I can write this way, 7 days and weeks, 7, 1 and 49, so what have we got here? So this we have to multiply and whatever is left behind that we have to divide here. So 49 upon 7. Now I know that 7 7 is 49. So what will be my answer? 7 weeks. 7 weeks, right? Suppose you have my 49 given, right? It would have given 48 or 45. So we calculate with that also. 48 days, and we have to convert it into the weeks and days, right? The same we will write here, days, 7, week, 1, here is 48, question mark, this both we have to multiply, whatever is left behind that we have to divide it. So 48 upon 7. Now I have to decide the table of a 7. 7 7 is a 49, I know. So here is the number that is less than 49. So 7 6 are. What I will do here? 48 divided by 7. 7 6 are 42. Okay? So 8 minus 2, 6, 0. So here whatever I have got, that is week, 6 weeks. And whatever is left behind, that are days. So 48 days means 6 weeks and 6 days. You have to understand, children? So this way we can convert the bigger unit to smaller unit by multiplying and smaller unit to bigger unit by dividing. Okay? Suppose if we take here the another example, 72 months convert into 1 and it is given 72 months. So months is the smaller unit and years is the bigger unit. So what we have to do? We have to divide. So what we will write here? Month 12. यहाँ कितने होते हैं? 1 year, right? So 72 कितने होंगे? This we have to multiply and this we have to divide. So 72 divided by 12. Now I have to give a decide the table of 12. So 12 6 are 72. So how many years I have got? 6 years. If we go to now 72. 5 minus 2, 3. So just now I explained you in the last sum, whatever quotient is there, that is showing here, and remainder is months, right? So what I will write here? 6 years and 3 months. Understand? Okay, now one more example in which we are of the story. Years and months. Here it is 4 years and 9 months, and 6 years and 10 months. So find how long she studied in the school. So I have put the total kitne saal school mein padhai tha, is what I have to add. Okay, so first what I mean, I cannot subtract this. So this is 19 months, so I have to subtract 1 year from it, 12 months, 1 year is equal to 12 months, right? So I have to subtract that, 9 minus 2, 7, here is the 0, 1 complete year, I have to carry here, 6 plus 4, 10 plus 1, 11. So how long she studied? 11 years and 7 months. So, he studied 11 years and 7 months in school. Understand, children? I hope your all doubts should be clear here. I have explained you whole chapter. This time I will be sending you only one part, because I have covered the whole chapter in that. The conversion, addition and subtraction, and AM, PM, how you can denote the AM and PM also, and with the different units also, right? So this was all for the day. Thank you and have a nice day.